Hi, welcome back to the Building 9 Space Vehicle Mock-up Facility at Johnson Space Center. The NEMO 16 training is still going on behind us, and now we have with us the commander of the NEMO 16 mission, Dottie Metcalf-Lindenberger. Thanks so much for talking with us, Dottie.
It's a pleasure. Thank you.
So how did you get involved in NEMO?
Well, we were actually selected as a crew, so we're announced and selected based on probably some skill sets and what we are. We're an international team, so definitely participation from all of our IPs, so mm-hmm. that was really important.
Okay, yeah, you've got a couple of international astronauts who are part of the crew this year.
It's very exciting, yes.
One from the European Space Agency and one from the Japanese Aerospace Exploration Agency, and then also a university professor.
Yes, it's exciting. A great crew, great mix of experience and just international partners. It's going to be great.
Good, good. So now you have, of course, been into space. And now we're going to go down and do a mission on the ocean floor. That's pretty right. much the whole gamut. That's got to be an accomplishment.
Yeah, I thought about that too, going from being about 240 miles up to going down. At this point, we're going to be about 60 feet during the day and living at about 40 feet under mm-hmm. the water. But it's pretty cool.
Yeah.
And both, if you think about it, both are definitely extreme environments. That's why we picked them for NASA. Mm-hmm. And of course, working in space is what we're doing and going to keep doing, but NEMO's going to offer us a lot of support for the future. So that part, that's one of the reasons why we're going.
I'm sure, yeah. I guess it's probably exciting for you to get your hands on some of that as well.
Absolutely. As you can see behind us, we're trying out some of the tools that we'll be using mm-hmm. and thinking about as you are working near an asteroid, just maybe would these tools work? What wouldn't work about them? And so you can see there's all sorts of things going on behind us.
Yeah, so and I guess we've got somebody in a harness right now, and then you're going to be getting into that a little later today,
yeah.
right?
Yes. So that's Argos has been, it's fantastic. I've used it actually to practice spacewalking for the Neutral Buoyancy Lab and what we do up on the International Space Station. Mm-hmm. But they've completely converted that scenario into what would look like maybe some asteroid materials and we've got the stretched out line there. So they can do a lot at this facility. It's great.
Yeah, apparently space or underwater, whatever
you need.
That's
right.
All right. Well, so what, I guess the mission's going to be about 12 days long, June 11th through 22nd.
Mm-hmm.
And so you're going to be living underwater all that time, I guess with in a small space, just like
right,
would
just
be
like
on the space
being
station.
On the International Space Station, smaller quarters, although still like it's a habitat, so you still have quite a bit of space there, mm-hmm. but yes, definitely confined, except for that we will be doing spacewalks every day. Mm-hmm. So in fact, two in the morning, two folks will go out and two will be inside. One will be like the IV crew member or the intervehicular crew member who's mm-hmm. giving all the instructions. And then that team will switch out and the next folks will go outside and then one of those folks will be another IV crew member. So mm-hmm. it's different than what we do in space where you just do one spacewalk on one day, but this will give us a lot of experience, get everyone participating on the tools mm-hmm. and talking the same language and helping out that way.
And I guess you're probably used to diving from the Neutral Buoyancy Laboratory where we practice the spacewalks.
That's
right?
Correct. We do a lot of diving at the Neutral Buoyancy Lab. There, you know, you have a depth of 40 feet as a max, and you have very clean water, and you have What we'll experience the same down in Florida, hopefully, is we'll have clear water. We'll actually have environment around us, so that'll be exciting to have fish and coral mm-hmm. and that type of differences. But again, both places were supported by extra divers and helping us to keep safe and also help the test pull off correctly.
Okay. Well, anything in particular you're looking forward to?
Wow, I'm looking forward to the whole learning experience. This week is really exciting with the training, and we just came together today as a team, and already you can see we're having a lot of fun, but really practical fun. And then I'm, of course, looking forward to the mission itself and living down there for 2 weeks and conducting really good science, as well as just meeting each other as a team, mm-hmm. because we all are going to be working together for years to come. So. That part's exciting too.
Okay, well hopefully we'll be able to check back in with you during the mission in June and hear how it's going. So good luck and thanks so much for talking with us.
Thank you, Randy.
Thank you.